I've gone through 4 gears. Oh man, and I already can't feel my nuts because of these, this seatbelt, but we're good. Holy clutch, man. There we go. Wow, I'm gonna have to like yell in this car. So today, I'm bringing you something huge. This is a 2008 Porsche 911 GT3. But it's not just a GT3, because if you notice, I've got a cage behind me, and I've got lots of extra goodies, as if you couldn't tell in the beginning of the video. This car, and I absolutely love being able to say this, this car is almost 100% track miles. It is a full-out race car, and it's driven very well and driven a lot. And I very, very much can appreciate that from a car of this magnitude. So in 2007 and 2008, you had the Mark 1, or the Dot 1, or whatever you want to call it. You had the Mark 1 GT3. That came with a 3.6 liter, and this is obviously not just your average 911. Now, a cool statistic with these cars is there are about 85% of GT3 owners that actually track their cars. So it's cool, like seeing that this is just in this very nature of what this car actually is, it's being used in the correct way. And I am having to talk so loud right now, but it's such a great feeling. Oh, this is so cool. It's got huge brakes. You've got 6 piston brakes up front. You've got 4 pistons in the rear. Now, this car did actually come with carbon ceramics, but because it's tracked, it's actually been replaced with steel brakes. So it's got giant, gigantic slotted steel brakes in this car. And it's got suspension upgrades. It's got huge wheels and tires. I mean, it's got some super fat wheels and tires on the back, and it's just meant for grip. From the factory, this car was meant to feel raw. So that's what's really special about these cars. As you get into it, there's no like stability and like traction. There's really not much helping you out. It kind of just brings it back to the good old days. It kind of celebrates the greatness of the old style like Porsche race car. Now, it's not an RSR, it's not an RS, it's not anything like that, but still, it goes back to the good old days where everything was just the driver, the steering wheel, and your own inputs, and then the car. And if you mess up, that's your own damn fault. This is probably one of the stiffest clutches I think I've ever had to. It's a solid feeling though. One of my favorite things about Porsche is just the sound of their naturally aspirated boxer motors. It's really one of a kind. It's just a party in your ears every second you're driving this car. I mean, you can hear little things like from the transmission, and you can hear just noise. It's the best noises that a car enthusiast wants to hear. And I'm going through these corners. I'm not even going very fast, but it's like, oops, I just hit a squirrel or something. 10 points. That's so awesome. This car is extremely, extremely responsive, and there's not a whole lot of like, the steering is it's just really great throttle response. You have to give the brakes a lot of balls. Like if you want to stop, you have to really get into them. Oh, it's just such a good car. I mean, the aero on this car is magnificent. It's really low to the ground. It's got very sticky tires. I feel like I should be driving in a Le Mans event right now. Like, I feel like I should be in the 24-hour, like, in full, like, race suit, flame retardant suit, helmet, everything like that. Like, I feel like I'm just one step away from walking out of my car and getting the trophy. It's cool, because every Porsche I've ever gotten into, it's just put a smile on my face. Just because of the nature of the car, with the rear engine, like, it's just such a solid, solid feeling. And it's something that's almost indescribable at sometimes. But it's just like, you feel so connected to the ground. You've got a super, super low center of gravity with the car. And it's just like, it's just there for you. Like, you're just having the time of your life 100% of the time that you're driving the car. It's awesome. So let's talk a little bit about the upgrades of the car. Oh, that was a really great rev match. I love that sound. So it's got the cage, as you can see, it's got a 4-point cage. It's gotten a lot of work done by a local company up here who actually sponsored my track days, called Catchell Motor Company. So KMC is what I actually put it in the videos. But Catchell Motor Company did a lot of work to this car. And this car is just used and abused in just the best ways possible. Oh, you just hear the big brake squeak. I mean, it's just like, I am alive right now. This car has balls. God, this is awesome. It's got the Alcantara steering wheel. It really reminds you of like an OMP style wheel. So it's got like the, it's got the little yellow stripe up top to know where you're centered. I mean, it's just, it's got a lot of just really, really cool additions to the car. The transmission feels wonderful. Now, from the factory, these transmissions are kind of iffy. The differential to these cars always kind of gives out. So this one actually has an upgraded rear diff. And supposedly as well, the transmissions to these cars are not the greatest in the world as well. They are pretty spectacular, but when you beat the hell out of the car on the track, stuff like that can happen. So, but from what I can tell, I mean, just it's spectacular. Like, you can shift it very easily. You feel really, really connected to the car. There's a lot of throttle response. You just really just, there's not a lot of electronic assistance like to help you out with the car, which I love. Like, when you drive a car that has no traction control, no stability control, all that kind of stuff, like it almost feels like I'm driving, you know, it's like a, it's pretty terrible to say this, but it's like I'm driving a big, big cup Miata with like no power steering. It's just, you're just, it feels raw. I love it. And I want to emphasize that. Like, this car feels so raw. Fairly stiff suspension. I mean, it's just like, I almost hate how overconfident this car makes me feel. It just gives you a lot of reassurance that it's like, you know what? I got you. You can have fun. It's kind of like it's a good feeling. It's an indescribable feeling, but it's a good feeling. Here we go. Oh man, so ballsy. And then air the brakes. Okay, here we go again. Awesome, man. This is great. This thing handles and drives like a dream. Oh, it's no wonder people love these so much. So something really cool about this car as well is, you know, I gave you the statistic of how many people actually track these cars that own them. Really cool thing is this car was bought with 3,000 miles on it and now has a little over 14,000. Like I said earlier, almost 100% of those miles are track miles. So you have almost 11,000 miles just dedicated to the track alone. I mean, so, like I said, this is a track prepped and track used car. It's very cool. Very cool to know that people actually buy these cars and use them for the purposes that they were designed for. Here we go. Oh, $6,000, it just goes. Oh my gosh. Dude, as soon as you hit $6,000 in this car, it's just like, yes, 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 yes. It's like it's just been sitting in the car. It's like the motor's just been waiting to hit it. And all of a sudden you hit it and it's just like, yes, I've been waiting for this moment to happen. God dang. This car is a demon. You know, maybe this is a good thing, maybe this is a bad thing, but like just driving in this car makes you feel like you could be a pro driver. The amount of control that this car has, it's such a little cost and such a little amount of input. It's so incredible. This is my favorite. This car has been absolutely incredible. Thank you guys so incredibly much for watching, and thank you to the owner and then also for Catchell Motor Company for building such a great car and you know, just for letting me drive it. This has been an experience of a lifetime. If you guys didn't know, Porsches are my favorite cars in this world, and for good reason. And I hope I kind of hourly express that reasoning. during this video. If I didn't, then shame on me, but I absolutely love this car. Thank you guys so incredibly much for watching. Hit that subscribe button and I will see you guys next video. Peace out. I can't reach the camera. I usually smack it, but yeah, now you're recording. Yeah, so if I have to have you do that again, now you know.
Titties in my face.
That's right.